Hi guys, it's April and it's been a hot minute. Sorry about that. Life got a little bit crazy. But I think we're back on track and I think we're gonna have some interesting fun with this piece. I want to do the sky next. So that's kind of where I'm going with this. I've pulled out the colors that I think I'm going to need. I have a white, which for the Holbeins is 500. I have a cherry blossom, which is 011. I've got an ivory, which is 116. A cream, which is 127. I brought back the lilac, which is 422. I pulled out the lavender blue, which is 328. I've got the Saxe blue, which is 395, and then I have the smoke blue, which is 379, because a lot of these clouds have some of that purple undertone, kind of like the tree, which is why I've got that lavender blue and the lilac. But yeah. So I'm probably going to start with the clouds so I can get those pretty solidly in place, and then I'll come back with like the blues and stuff and finish out the sky, because I have a feeling trying to get those clouds the way I want them to is going to be a little bit of an adventure. So we'll see what actually happens. I'm gonna move those aside so I don't accidentally knock them. And then these are what we're going to be working with. I'm going to. Yeah, it is kind of interesting how that tree is kind of just like in, just on the page. It's the only thing on the page and the effect that kind of has. But I'm going to zoom in before we even get started. There we go. Okay, so I'm gonna start with the white. And I'm gonna kind of put. Some white down around here. And I'll be honest, you're not gonna see a lot of what I'm doing. I can't even see a lot of what I'm doing right now. The joys of working with white first on white. Don't recommend it. But kind of need to get. Okay, so yes, you saw literally nothing of what just went down. I'm gonna pull the cherry blossom, and the cherry blossom I brought mainly because you've got some of these pinky tones over here because I think the sun is starting to rise over on this. Oh, you can't even see. On the picture, on that side of the picture, off the frame of the actual picture itself, I think the sun is starting to rise. So you're getting some of those yellows and those pinky hues. So on this side of the page, you've got some of that starting to show up. So I'm probably not going to use a lot of the pinks and such, but there are hints of it. It's interesting how subtle Kincaid is.
with his colors. Okay, and then I've got this ivory, which has actually got a little bit of a yellow tone to it. We'll add a little bit of that sun reflection to those clouds. Grab a pink real quick. Okay, and then there's only a small part where I'm going to use this cream on, because there's only this very edge right here that has a very highlighted yellow part. And I understand that I can't quite see what's going on in the picture right now, but it will show up, I promise. I think I'm gonna actually need smoke for some of the darker parts of these clouds. Okay. I'm gonna go in here lightly. And just get the whole base of the cloud in. And then we'll go back and start adding a lot of definition. Bring the white back real quick. We don't want to lose these highlights as we build up. Now I'm going to quickly sharpen my smoke blue. And that very, very quickly. Starts to add quite a bit of depth. Sunlight keeps changing on me. Got a lot of clouds. Coming in and out. Looking really weird. So at this point, it's kind of just building up those layers. Okay, make sure I don't lose the tower.
I don't know if it looks like much right now. I don't want to lose the definition of those tree branches. Oops. Hi, Tara. We're doing better than we have been. And that is honestly my goal in life right now. Been a rough couple of weeks. We're finding a balance with the animals and the new kitten and everything else. So it's a little easier to breathe in the house because there's not quite so much tension. Which I will admit is nice. So I might have to wait to fully finish the cloud until I get the sky in place so I actually can see a little bit of what I'm doing. So I'm gonna quickly move to these upper clouds. Get some
these started, and then once I get those in place, we can hit the sky and maybe you start to see some definition of those clouds that it's hard to see when you're coloring something light. Switch over to the blues real quick. Kind of get foundation of all of these down. Just kind of doing a light base. I almost need. This is almost too blue. I almost need something with a little bit of. Gray in it. Maybe something a little deeper and a little richer for that top section. What do I want to pull in for that? Because I got the Sax blue, which was supposed to have that deepness to it that I wanted. It isn't quite. Maybe I'll pull a navy blue, but I'll keep it light-handed so I don't, like, overdo it. I am quite loving the fact that I don't have to work so hard around those lines, because holy cow, I remember doing the clouds in Tangled and how much work that was. And that was not fun in any way, shape, or form of the word. See, and that almost adds too much blueiness to it. I will admit that you do have to kind of learn how to work around the texture of the gouache. Which is a bit of a learning curve. And I think that's a little bit of what I'm fighting right now. Oh man, that tip is gone. It just. Story of my life. I might pull some of that smoke blue. Maybe that'll soften out that current blue I'm using. I'm almost going almost too classic blue sky, and that is not at all what I wanted. How do I feel about this right now? And I know the clouds aren't like super distinct. In the comparison, I'm going to actually zoom out so you can start to see. What I'm working with. See, I've almost made it. Too blue. I don't know if I can necessarily pull back from that. Yeah, it almost added like a blue green to it, but it didn't intend to do. I think it was that navy, which is weird. I need like a soft blue gray, which is originally why I pulled out the Saks blue. But it's not. Not hitting the way I want it to. Okay. I might do that. That might work. Okay, so if I want to pull back on a blue, most of the time you add a yellow. I wanted to pull back on green. You would add a magenta. I guess there's not a lot of green in there. I could try adding a little bit of yellow up there to see if I can like mute that blue a little bit. So the cream and the ivory that I've got going on. I also might just come through with an eraser and see. Yeah, the yellow is, I think, just gonna mess things up. Problem solving on the fly. has to be. The real question is, do I, since I can't find a color in this, pull out my polychromos and see if there is a color in there? That would do what I want. Oh, of course, I just spilled my drink. Oh, welcome to the circus. Okay, that was disaster averted. Goodness gracious. Okay, we were just talking about possibly adding a little bit of lilac up there. Maybe bring some of that down. I am, yep, nope, klutz, 100%, always. Ask anybody who knows me. I mean, you guys have witnessed some of the results of my full-on klutz. What, last year I had my hand bandaged for how many months because of a incident with a hot pan and a cat, and the number of stitches I've had to have because of various different knives and things. To be softened a little bit over there. This feeds into all of that. I'm trying to add something, I'm trying to add definition to something that by nature doesn't have a lot of definition. Clouds. I love how when I get super aggressive with coloring, I make the whole table shake. You know what? I am not disliking where it's going. This is true. I mean, it could have been far worse, and I prefer I get the burn than the cat get the burn. But it's the fact that the burn happened after I saved the cat, because the whole reason I saved the cat was because the pan was hot. And then I got the cat away and then turned around and grabbed the pot with my bare hands because logic. If what is this? This is a warm gray. Don't think I'll be mad at that. Ooh, what is that? What is that? Ooh. All of a sudden I can see that line. I must have scraped that off. Well, that's not good. So note to self that you can accidentally remove the gesso. And of course, both of my white Poscas are going to be a butt today. Well, maybe I'll get this Posca going. So it's one of those things. Where gesso works amazing for this concept. The only issue being, if you're too aggressive with your colored pencils, you can still totally take it off the page. Which is actually pretty true of using Posca as well. Okay. But I might is some Vaseline to see if I can kind of smooth out that sky a little bit. I think part of what's driving me nuts is the fact that I can't quite smooth out the texture that's going on right now. Put a string of Vaseline on the picture.
I'm bound and determined to get this to a point that I'm happy with. Do I 100% know what that looks like? No. yes. Such is the dread of a Kincaid picture, is the fact that he doesn't use a color to make a color. He uses like 17 colors to make a color. And they're not thoroughly mixed. So when he throws it onto the canvas, you get this effect of there might be this like weird light yellow streak through something that you kind of have to like figure out how to fade in, or just decide that nope, you're gonna ignore it. Hence why I'm like, there's a little bit of pinky stuff down here, and then there's a little bit of yellow going on over here. How the heck am I gonna add all of that? I don't know. Where is my sax and my spark blue? Where is my sax blue? Okay. Lilac up in there. Gotten to the point where I'm being too aggressive and I'm actually pulling some of that gesso off, which is exactly what I don't want to do. So I might just have to be happy with where this is sitting. In the whole dynamic of this background, while it seems just a little light to me at the moment, once I start getting the rest of the page in, it might start flowing together a little bit better. Because, I mean, there isn't really a lot of high-definition parts in this area of the picture. So I might have sort of shot myself a little bit in the foot, deciding that this would be one of the first things I do. It's just, I kind of got excited about the possibility of developing these clouds without having to deal with those ridiculously harsh lines.
I suppose that's true. I mean, I did spend over a year doing that. Well, it was about a year doing that Thomas or the Kirby Rosanne's crystal page. 'Cause once again, I got this brilliant idea in my head, and I kind of shot myself in my own foot. Oh my gosh! Oh, the paint is peeling off the page. You need to just like leave this corner alone. Okay, so I found a small. Fault in the whole. Gesso plan. And that seems to be that I am super aggressive at times. And I can actually pull that gesso right off the page. Oh, yeah, so that corner is going to look a little bit rough. Definitely a learning curve. Not going to lie. Well, see, the only thing with pastels, if I'd done the sky in pastels, there's some fine definition. I don't know if I would have gotten some of those fine, like, highlights in the clouds if I had used pastels. Those fine highlights are pretty much what make those clouds. It's going to be interesting trying to get that tower in there. Because you have those spires that go up into the clouds. I can only see so much of the lines.
I also think some of what I'm doing is getting lost in the camera, trying to find the white balance in the contrast, because I am working with such light colors. I think it's going to show up better when I take a picture of it and I can put it up, of course, on the community tab and on Twitter and on Instagram for you to take a look at what's like actually happening. Because like I said, I feel like some of it is getting a little lost in translation. I certainly want to take all of the blue off. You have a good day too, Tara. I'm glad you could stop by. I am almost about to call this anyways, because I think I run the risk of overworking this section if I don't. I don't necessarily want that.
Just. Course. Be fun to use the Posca a little bit. Some fun with some of the edges here. To get a new Posca. This one I think is on its very last leg. Okay, yes. I need to walk away. Otherwise, I am going to put this whole thing in a place where I'm not going to be happy, and it's going to be a whole event. As I pick up a pencil and, you know, continue on and keep doing stuff. Okay, yes. So here's the thing. I will take a picture of this. Like I said, I will put it on all of my various different pages so that you can see it from a slightly different perspective. I don't think my webcam is picking it up very well. It's not as muddy, I think, in real life as what's going on with whatever is going on. But we will be back. I will be back. Next. Sorry, I'm looking at some of this skyline and I'm not thrilled about it. Okay, it's something for me to fix next week. But I will be back next week, same time, same place, and we'll continue to fill out this page. And I think the sky is going to start to feel more real to what it needs to be. That's the only thing about doing this page in sections is sometimes you kind of lose perspective of how everything's sitting on a page. So next weekend, I will probably do some of the trees and the mountainy stuff that's going on in the background and start to make that sky feel like it's not just there by itself. And we may be doing some more manipulation of that sky as we go on in this page to make it all feel like a cohesive unit. We're kind of in that messy stage of the project where things don't quite feel how you want them to feel, but they'll get there. I promise they'll get there. I want to thank each and every one of you for coming and hanging out with me today. I love that you do, and even if you're just a silent lurker, you're awesome, you're amazing, and I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your weekend, and I hope to see you again next week.